This is a multi-agent programming and modeling environment. It comes with an extensive model library for various domains. Written in Java, NetLogo is a member of Lisp, which supports agents and concurrency. The NetLogo world is made up of agents. There are mainly four types of agents. Turtles, which move around in the world. The world is a two-dimensional grid of patches. Links are agents that connect two turtles. Links can be directed or undirected. The observer doesn't have a location. Taking a little bit a look at NetLogo variables. A variable can be global variable, turtle variable, a patch, a link, or a local variable. Next, looking at the summary of NetLogo, we can say that it is very easy to set up and run models, but the limitation is that it cannot be easily extended. And finally, NetLogo is used in a variety of applications, including educational applications, game development, and 2D geometry and geography tools. The next language is TripleAPL. TripleAPL is an agent programming language based on the concept of an intelligent agent. The programming logic is a variant of a modal logic. It uses a combination of imperative programming and logic programming. The basic components are beliefs and goals. In TripleAPL, beliefs are formula from a first-order language. First-order terms are defined by means of given sets of first-order variables and function symbols. In general, the implementation of a multi-agent system requires two programming languages. One single-agent programming language to implement individual agents, and one multi-agent programming language to implement multiple agent aspects such as which and how individual agents should be executed. The belief base is implemented by a prolog program consisting of prolog facts and rules. The TripleAPL platform provides a user interface that allows TripleAPL agents to be programmed, loaded, and executed. These diagrams show the architectures of 3APL platform and individual 3APL agents. Applications of TripleAPL include high-level control of mobile robots, small device mobile applications, and control behavior of Sony AIDO robots. Moving on, let us look at Prolog. Prolog is a type of logic programming. It uses predicate logic as the building block for programming. Prolog is the most widely used language to have been inspired by logic. Learning of Prolog includes the following: writing facts, querying, and writing rules. Prolog uses logical variables. These are not the same as variables in other languages. A Prolog program can also be used as a relational database containing rules as well as facts. Prolog has many advantages. Some of the main are it can be compiled into efficient code, it has more expressive power, the declaration of variable names is not required. On the other hand, there are some bottlenecks as well. Some of them are that it is slow, it requires a lot of memory, and also does not have real-time capability. Now, taking a look at the applications, Prolog is well suited for the racetrack application, compile design, digital electronic circuit verification, proving program correctness is one other important feature. And another architecture using agent-based system is known as SOAR. SOAR is a general cognitive architecture for developing systems that exhibit intelligent behavior. SOAR architecture has a number of features worth noting. It works on the full range of tasks expected of an intelligent agent. It represents and uses appropriate forms of knowledge, and it interacts with the outside world. Also, it learns about all aspects of the task and its performance on them. The primary principle of SOAR is that all decisions are made through the combination of relevant knowledge at runtime. Every decision is based on the current interpretation of sensory data, the contents of working memory, and any relevant knowledge retrieved from long-term memory. And finally, decisions are never pre-compiled into uninterruptible sequences. As shown in the diagram, working memory contains the data representing current progress on all goals. Data is organized into objects consisting of a symbolic identifier and augmentations. Conditions are matched against working memory and can contain variables. The actions create preferences for changes to working memory. All matched productions are fired in parallel. Now let's move on to another language called TeleScript. The TeleScript language is an object-oriented remote programming language. It supplements rather than replaces systems programming language like C and C++, and only the parts of an application that move from one place to another, like agents or hosts visiting agents, are written in this language. There are four main language characteristics of TeleScript. The first one is safety. The language prevents an agent from directly manipulating its host computer or interacting with other agents without their approval. This helps prevent the spread of viruses. The next one is portability. The language makes no concession to the hardware or software constraints of a particular computer. This means that an agent or place can be executed anywhere in a network. Another characteristic is elevation. The language makes no distinction between volatile and non-volatile storage. Every information object is persistent. This increases an agent's level of abstraction and decreases its size. And finally, extendability. The language gives to classes of information objects that the programmer defines the stature of classes that are built into the language. This lets the language to be extended for particular purposes. Well, that was a look at different programming languages, applications, as well as mechanisms of each. We do hope that you have learned something new from this presentation, and I would like to thank you for watching.